Still to come at 2, it's Mark and Lard. At 1, the Live Lounge. Right now, it's Gary Davis.
BBC Radio 1 Vintage.
Hi, this is Gary Davis. I was at Radio 1 from 1982 to 1993. Well, I was working for a local radio station in Manchester. And one day I was out shopping and I ended up in this shop and there were loads of pictures of the Radio 1 DJs in these white puffer jackets, which used to be like the Radio 1 DJ's standard outfit. I said to the person working there, I said, how come you got all these pictures of Radio 1 DJs on the wall? They said, well, our boss makes the jackets for the DJs. I said, oh, cool. I said, I'd like to meet him, you know. Ended up meeting him, John, and he said to me, listen, if you ever want a tape going to Radio 1, he said, I know everybody there. He said, I'm very happy to pass a tape on. And I said, great, I think I might take you up on that. So I sent my tape in. The next thing I know is one morning, John gave me a call early in the morning and he says, it's between you and a girl as to who gets the job at Radio 1. And I said, what? He said, yeah, it's between you and a girl. He says, I'll call you back. So I didn't hear anything for a few hours, and then a few hours later, he calls me back. He says, I'm sorry, mate. He said, the girl's got it. I said, what? He said, yeah, the girl's got it. But he said, you have too as well. And the girl was Janice Long, and sort of got a 3-month contract, 10 till 12 on a Saturday night to do a show, and 3 months turned into 11 years. The jingle came about because of the Kane Gang. The Kane Gang had a single called Small Town Creed, and they just did this jingle that just went, woo, Gary Davis. And, you know, the second I heard it, I just thought, you know what? This is really going to catch on. It was just so hooky. And it was probably the biggest success the Kane Gang ever had. And then on the back of that, when I had artists and guests on the show, I would get them to do versions of the jingle. I remember once I was doing a phone call and this woman said, oh, my little son, he loves your jingle. Can he do it now? And he did it on the radio and we recorded it, and then we turned that into another jingle.
Woo, Gary Davis. Woo, Gary Davis.
Yeah, we had a lot of fun with that.
Woo, Gary Davis, on your radio.
Basically, it was a lunchtime show and it literally was the bit in the middle. You know, Simon Bates was in the morning, Steve Wright was in the afternoon, and I was the bit in the middle. There's actually a really good story in, I think it was 87, there was a big hurricane. And it was at the time that we were doing Gary Goes to Your Place, which is the show on the road, visiting people who'd written in, saying, you know, come and pop in.
Talking to you in the middle of an industrial estate.
And we were doing Crawley, and the southeast was pretty much where this hurricane was hitting the most. We'd be driving along on the motorway and we'd see lorries like tip over in front of us. This is all while we're broadcasting live. And I remember someone wrote in who had a pet shop saying, you know, come visit us in the pet shop. And we got to the pet shop and the roof had blown off and all these birds had flown away. And it was just one of those things where it was just literally flying by the seat of your pants. But that's the beauty of live radio.
You look a little bit dumbstruck, aren't you?
The best thing for me, it was the music and the freedom at that time that you had. I could literally play whatever I wanted. I mean, it could be like 808 State, Pacific State, where I heard that track at 6:30 in the morning in Amnesia in Ibiza, and I, you know, the song just blew me away, and I tracked down the song and started playing it on the radio. Whether it was the Gypsy Kings, I heard Bambaleo. You know, again while I was travelling, and then brought that back and started playing it on the radio. I think I was the first person to play Radiohead. But I'm a creep. I love the dance explosion as well, so, you know, things like French Kiss from Lil Louis. Technotronic, Pump Up the Jam.
Pump up the jam, pump it up, while your feet are stumping.
This is all stuff that was, you know, pioneering the dance explosion of the late 80s.
Pump it up a little more, get the party going on the dance floor.
I think my time at Radio 1 is amongst the best time of my life. It's just the best job in the world.
To hear the full interview, download the podcast at bbc.co.uk/Radio 1 Vintage.
Radio 1. The UK's favourite DJs. Gary Davis.
Woo, Gary Davis.
Five foot ten and a half, faded suntan, smooth, suave, sophisticated, and the moment that you have been waiting for, an inside leg measurement of... Oh, Kitty, you've come in. Oh, come in for the night. Yeah, I'll get you a dinner in a sec. You just go over there in the corner of the studio. Make yourself at home, Kitty.
They put a parking lot on a piece of land where the supermarket used to stand. Before that, they put up a bowling alley on the site that used to be the local pally. That's where the big band used to come and play. My sister went there on a Saturday. Come dancing, all her boyfriends used to come and call. Why not come dancing? It's only natural. Another Saturday, another date. She would be ready, but she'd always make him wait. In the hallway, in anticipation. He didn't know the night would end up in frustration. He'd end up blowing all his wages for the week. Or for a cuddle and a peck on the cheek. Come dancing, that's how they did it when I was just a kid. And when they said come dancing, my sister always did. Should have come in at midnight, and my mom would always sit up and wait. It always ended up in a big row when my sister used to get home late. Out of my window I could see them in the moonlight, two silhouettes saying goodnight by the garden gate. The day they knocked down the pally, my sister
sister's married and she lives on an estate. Her daughters go out, now it's her turn to wait. She knows they get away with things she never could. But if I asked her, I wonder if she would.
I'm dancing.
Come on, sister, have yourself a ball. Don't be afraid to come dancing. It's only natural.
Ladies and gentlemen, Medallion Man.
Action! Action Radio!
Radio 1! The day-to-day challenge with Gary Davis!
A2.
We welcome back Jonathan Hogg from Audley Edge in Cheshire. Hi, Jonathan.
Hi, Gazza.
How you doing? All right?
Great, yeah. Yeah. Hang on, got the Motley Crue here.
Oh, dear.
Oh, Gary Davis, who's not a celebrity! Hey!
Are they drunk or what?
They're always like this.
How many have you got there?
Four.
Is your bistro actually open at lunchtime?
No.
Thank God. Scare away all your customers, wouldn't you? So what, you're just getting prepared for tonight?
Yeah, they'll get ready and do a lot of my book work and everything like that. So.
Yeah. How was your week?
Busy day Monday.
How was your weekend?
Super. Great time.
Yeah? What did you get up to?
Yeah, well, obviously working Saturday, getting prepared for Saturday night. I had a busy night and yesterday went out for a drink at lunchtime with my sister Fiona and fiancé Robert. Did some work in the afternoon and took Maria out for dinner last night.
Oh, that's nice.
Yeah.
Yeah. How is your wife?
Oh, she's very well.
How did you two get together?
That's a long story. I first asked her out about 10 years ago.
Yeah.
And she refused. and then there was a big gap between for about 8 years. And we met again somehow. And she asked me out then.
She asked you out.
Yeah.
What changed her mind?
I don't know. I think she realised what she was missing.
What, she was desperate? Oh, no, I'm only joking. So, is she there now?
Yeah.
Yeah? Going red?
Just a little bit.
Listen, day two, Jonathan.
Yeah.
You've already won yourself a Radio 1 sports bag.
Sorry, just showing enthusiasm.
Oh, that's good. I like it. I like your style. And today you're going for 5 singles to go in the bag.
Yeah.
Oops. What on earth is that?
Sorry, it's a bit windy up here, sorry.
Fine. Quiet. You've always been eating your own food. All right, it's general knowledge and I can't help you at all, okay?
Yeah, okay.
You're going to have to work this out yourself.
Right.
Okay, question one. Can you tell me the name of the holy book of the Muslim religion? Is it A, the Torah, or B, the Quran?
The Quran.
Yeah. Torah is a term used widely, obviously, to describe the whole of the Jewish religion's teachings. Question two. If you have conjunctivitis, it's not easy to say. If you have conjunctivitis, you have inflammation affecting which of the following? Is it A, the eyelids, or B, the earlobes?
Eyelids.
Correct. So you sailed through the first two, didn't you?
Oh, I've got some great help here.
Have you? What, they didn't help you at all, you mean?
Yes.
it's probably the best type of help, because if they'd given you a wrong answer, you'd never have forgiven them.
Yeah, that's true. I'd have sacked them.
One more question to go. You ready?
Yes.
Okay. The substance sodium hydroxide is used in the home. What is it more commonly known as, sodium hydroxide? Is it A, salt, or B, caustic soda?
Caustic soda.
Yeah! Well done. Will you lay off that wind machine, please? It just sounds awful. Say you live to fight another day. Mystery voice tomorrow.
Oh, no.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, no. Can I have the specialist subject first?
No.
Oh, go on.
No. What is your specialist subject, by the way?
Derby County Football Club, 1968 to 78.
Really?
Yeah.
I suppose we've all got problems, really.
Yes, I know.
No, you can't.
Oh.
You're going to have to defeat the mystery voice first.
You're a hard man, Davis.
I am. Very hard. So we'll do that tomorrow. All right, Jonathan?
Great, okay.
Have a good day.
And you.
Bye.
Gary Davis. Gary Davis. Gary Davis. On your radio. Yeah.
The best sound in Britain. Radio 1.
Every time I think of you, I always catch my breath, and I'm still standing here, and you're miles away, and I'm wondering why you left. And there's a storm that's raging through my frozen heart tonight. I hear your name in certain circles, and it all time thinking about you. desperate I've become, and it looks like I'm losing this fight. In your world, I have no meaning, though I'm trying hard to understand. And it's my heart.
You're listening to Radio on Vintage. I'm Gary Davis. Still to come,
we have a serious Burnley posse hot on our tails here. Just have a listen to these horns if you can.
One of the coolest men in the business, Bob Geldof. Hello, mate.
Okay, not at the moment, mind you.
Oh, I don't know, you're looking cool. I mean, everybody around here is, they're all sweating buckets.
Well, I promised you a surprise on the programme, and unfortunately...
you couldn't, mate.
Phil Collins, hello.
Radio 1 Vintage.
My definition of a boombastic jazz style. Here we go, are you ready for one other? Dream Warriors noise is new, discover all. Once again with a new blend, so telephone a friend.
Yo, Dream Warriors got this new song, it's dope, man!
Compact disc to the prime is Optimist. Fans are friends, I'm universal and cosmic. Concrete jungles abound. By the speaker, you're smothered and covered up in the sound. You stand strong as you pump your fist. I'm talking all that jazz. Now what's my definition? My definition. My definition. My definition is this. My definition. My definition. My definition. My definition is this. My definition. My definition is this. My definition. Rhymes, it's often said to do damage. Skin so strong, even Superman needs a hand. So bob your head, dread, as I kick the funk flow. This rhyme is subliminal, yeah, you don't think so. I walk with a gold cane, a gold brain, and no gold chain. Behind the truth lies, there lies a parapet. In the mix is where Dream Warriors go. Define if you will, but I know so. There is no definition. My definition, my definition. My definition is this, my definition. My definition, my definition. My definition is this, my definition. My definition is this, my definition. Right now I know it's a flow, it just like a poet. Your definition of me is definitely wrong. Why must I try to lie and build an alibi? All you ask is just for me to be me. Replace a replaceable replacement with this. Relax, relax, relaxation, bombastic. My name is King Lou.
Mine is capital Q.
Bags of mostly water, search to find my definition. My definition. My definition. My definition is this. My definition. My definition. My definition. My definition is this. My definition. My definition is this. My definition.
My definition. My definition. My definition. My definition.
definition is this, my definition. My definition is this, my definition.
My definition of a boom-bastic jazz style.
Everybody go.
From the Dream Warriors is Radio 1 FM.
Ooh, Gary Davis.
Good afternoon to you, and welcome to another Gary Goes to Your Place. I'm talking to you in the middle of an industrial estate just on the outskirts of Burnley, the Rossendale Road Industrial Estate. It's a beautiful day. The sun is shining. We have a serious Burnley posse hot on our tails here. Just have a listen to these horns if you can. You probably can't hear them that clearly because they're quite a way behind us, but... Oh, yeah, you're getting those. We've probably got about 30 cars who are already following us around at the moment. We're going to... Thank you. We're going to bring Burnley to a standstill. So, we're just turning right out of Billington Road. There's some people in an Austin Metro in front of us. And there's five of them in there with a little kid as well. And they're looking around wondering, what on earth is all this noise? Where is it all coming from? Why is everyone honking? And are they honking at us? Now, why are we here? Well, I got a letter from Sharon Armitage. She said, in early September 84, I was lucky enough to be a contestant on your day-to-day challenge, managing to last the full 5 days. I also had the opportunity to meet you a few months later when you're doing a spot at the local club. Now, the point of my letter is this. Over the years, I've been a reasonably regular listener to Radio 1, except when I went to work in Manchester for 2 years. But one of my prizes from my time on Radio 1 was my Gary Davis keyring. Now, no matter where I managed to mislay those keys, they always turned up again pretty quickly, as everybody knew they belonged to me. They were so easily recognisable. Unfortunately, my son James was not quite so impressed with my souvenir and threw it down the toilet. Your picture got all soggy and the little plastic case kept breaking open, so I had to relegate my lucky keyring to the bin. So if at all possible, while you're in Burnley, if you could pop in here and drop me off another keyring, then that would be terrific. Well, I'm bringing Tracy and Melissa with me, and we're just moving here. It's a beautiful stone house, just walking up the drive. And there is Sharon and the two little ones just at the door here. Hang on, just staying up. Hello, Sharon!
Oh.
How you doing?
Not so bad, thank you.
Nice to see you.
You too, again.
Oh, is this the little monster here?
Terrible little monster.
Jade?
Yeah, she's crying because of the cold weather.
Ah. Little tears running down her cheek. She's cute, isn't she? Hello?
You don't have to live with her.
Ghost.
What?
You are a wrong ghost.
I'm at the wrong house. Which house should I be at?
To be at the different house.
Oh, can't I come in?
I don't notice I am a boss.
Oh. Is he
I'm
what?
The boss.
What did he say?
He said, I said no because I'm the boss. This is the in phrase. Every day this week, I am the boss.
Oh, he's the boss, isn't
yeah.
he? Do you want to come inside?
Everybody
can come inside.
Everybody can come
We're just
inside.
This house is brilliant. It's really nice. It looks old, but is it old?
That end of the house is about 19 years old, and this end of the house is a year old.
But were you born in Burnley?
Yes, but I moved away when I was 6.
Where'd you go to?
Canada.
To Canada?
Yes.
And then you came back?
No, 5 years just outside Montreal, four right. years in Massachusetts, and then back.
And is this your favourite place?
This is my husband.
Oh, wait, he's hiding in the background. What's his name?
Gary.
Oh, Gary, come over here, mate. How you doing? You don't mind us invading your house, do you, Gary?
I've no option, really.
What do you do, Gary?
Try and keep my eye on this lady so that she doesn't get me in trouble like this.
Are you in trouble now?
I think so, probably.
Why?
Well, she is. I've just brought an insurance claim. She's wrapped her car up this morning.
Oh, no! You didn't.
I didn't damage it that badly.
How much damage is there, Gary?
Looking at it, quite a bit.
Oh, I'm rich. This house is fantastic. It is really, really... Pardon?
I've cleaned it specially.
it's absolutely spot. Listen, I tell you what, you need in another Gary Davis keyring.
Oh, right.
Okay, well, I've got millions left
oh,
in the drawer.
You.
I can't get rid of them to anybody. So I might as well bring you one.
Thank you.
A four.
Thank
so,
you very much.
Hopefully the little one... You won't put that down the toilet now, will you?
Say yes.
Pay me a raspberry.
I think it's brilliant.
It's all right.
Thanks for having us here, Sharon.
It's quite all right. You're most welcome.
All right. We'll let you to face the fury of your hubby in the car.
Oh, he already knows about it. He's been up to check it once. He's just been back to pick up the form.
Okay, well, I hope you get it all sorted out. Thank you. I was back in the old days, long ago. When we were kids, when we were young, things seemed so perfect, you know. The days were endless, we were crazy, we were young. The sun was always shining, we just lived for fun. Sometimes it seems like lately, I just don't know. The rest of my life's been just a show. A surprise on the programme, and unfortunately,
you couldn't make it.
Phil Collins, hello.
Hello, Gary.
You just run here, haven't you?
Yeah, I ran from up the road because I didn't want to be late.
Is this part of the new Keep Fit campaign?
Well, I try my bit. I do my bit. I got a gym in my house, so I do that every other day as much as I can, you know, and the wife does it every other day.
Yeah.
We do it different
times. What, the
same day? No, we do it at different times. That's the way my life is, Gary.
What, doing it at different times?
Yeah, yeah. You start without me, it's all right.
The album's called But Seriously.
Dot, 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 But Seriously.
Does that mean it's a more serious album than your past?
Yeah, actually. Well, the reason, I mean, they're not all... There's a lot of tracks that is kind of lyrical content that you would expect from me, I suppose. But the thing is, the most important thing to me is there's an awful lot of stuff on there that you wouldn't expect from me. And I think that with Buster and Groovy Kind of Love and Two Hearts occupying the last 2 years, people think, kind of think that I'm going that direction a little bit more, a bit too cuddly. I don't want to be too cuddly, you know?
But you are cuddly.
Well, I'm all right.
Everybody
as a cuddly people go. But no, I mean, I started off doing what I do now as a drummer, singing, that writes his songs, you know, and so that's what I've gone back to on this album. And the lyrical content I wanted to try and put over in the title, because I say a lot of people wouldn't expect it from me. So the word seriously is actually, although it's a humorous, you know, but seriously is the kind of thing you say after a joke.
Sure.
So I kind of put it like that to show that I haven't lost my sense of humor, but at the same time there are some things on the album that are quite serious.
I've heard the single. It is brilliant. I have to say this. It really
wow.
is.
Thank you. Your check's in the post, Gary. Yeah. No, thank you very much.
Well done.
I haven't got much feedback from the album yet, because you make an album, you know, and then you put it out to people and you live with it for 5 or 6 months, and that's just the recording of it.
Yeah.
But get people's feedback from it is great.
I mean, I know it's very easy for me because you sat in front of me to say, yeah, it's brill, Phil, you know, but seriously. But seriously.
You see how easy it is.
Just tune into Radio 1.
Sexes.
Day four of the Battle of the Sexes, the final day. Mark Tinkler from Congleton in Cheshire is on 9 rungs of the lunchtime ladder. If he gets a one-step question right, then he wins the Battle of the Sexes and takes away with him a superb ghetto blaster. Pat Lunkin is on 4 rungs of the ladder, so whatever happens, well, hopefully, she'll take away at least some record tokens. Pat, hello.
Hello, Gary.
How you doing?
I'm fine, thank you.
You're well travelled, aren't you?
Oh, yes, indeed.
Apparently you just came back from the Canadian Rockies.
Oh, yes, that was magnificent. Alaska and the Canadian Rockies.
So how long were you away for?
2 weeks.
2 weeks? I'm really jealous.
Oh, you must go one day.
Hopefully, one day. Keep my fingers crossed, eh?
Yes.
Okay, Mark?
Hi, Gary.
How are you?
I'm all right, thanks.
Yeah, are you well-travelled?
Depends on what way you mean.
Well, have you been away a lot?
Yeah, I went to Florida last year with Joanne.
I went to Disney World.
Yeah, we went to Disney World, yeah.
Oh, what's it like?
Fantastic.
Yeah, because I can't wait. I'm going next week.
You'll really enjoy it.
Pardon?
You'll really enjoy it.
So, have been anywhere else apart from Florida?
Tenerife the year before.
Mm-hmm. Did you travel much because you were in the army, weren't you?
Yeah, I was. No, I didn't really. I just stayed in Aldershot.
See the world, Aldershot.
Yeah, seeing the world. Or around the south coast.
Yeah. All right, Mark, listen, you're in the lead. A one-step question will get you to the top of the lunchtime ladder.
Yeah.
And you could win yourself a ghetto blaster. 2 categories remaining. What would you like, athletics or American states?
Athletics.
Okay, American states for you, Pat.
Yes, indeed.
So, Mark, a one-step question on athletics will put you to the top of the ladder and you'll win Battle of the Sexes and a superb ghetto blaster.
I'll have a one, Gary.
You'll have a one?
Yeah.
You sure?
I'm sure.
Okay. Nice, easy one-step question for you. Name the British team who competed in the 1970 Olympics.
Pardon?
Sorry, I'm just having a bit of fun with you.
A bit of fun?
No, that was just a joke question.
All right.
Okay, here's your serious question, one-step question. Good luck.
Thanks.
At the 1908 London Olympics, in which event were 385 yards added to its length so that the race would finish in front of the Royal Box? At the 1908 London Olympics, in which event were 385 yards added to its length so that the race would finish in front of the Royal Box?
The marathon.
You're saying the marathon. If that's right, you win a ghetto blaster and Battle of the Sexes.
All right.
Well done, mate.
Thanks, Gary.
Very well done.
Hard luck, Pat.
Well done, Mark.
Thanks a lot.
Listen, Pat.
Yes.
4 rungs of the ladder, £2 of rungs, that's £8 worth of record tokens.
Lovely.
All right?
Yes, and don't forget my sweatshirt and T-shirt.
No, I won't forget that for your piano playing yesterday.
Oh, thank you very much. And can I just say hello to the boys of Ray Moss Air Tours at E4. They've been listening to me all the week and cheering me on.
Okay.
Thank you.
Great
very
to
much.
Talk to you, Pat.
Thank you.
Cheers.
Bye. Unbelievable.
are unbelievable.
Coming up on BBC Radio 1 Vintage. At 1, the Live Lounge.
It's Clara Amfo here, and I'm joined by two absolute dons of Radio 1, the lovely Fern Cotton, hello.
Hello.
And Joe Wiley.
Hi.
So today on the show, Fern and Joe are picking their favourite live lounges.
Look at the stars, look how they shine for you.
Oh, I'll get them hot, show them what I've got.
Stadiums and shady spitzes flow. Nuts they go, macadamia and they go so ballistic, whoa.
But you paid it, you paid it.
I rock a mic like a vandal, light up a stage and wax a chump like a candle. Dance, crush a speaker that booms. I'm killing your brain like a poisonous mushroom. Deadly, when I play a dope melody, anything less than the best is a felony. Love it or leave it, you better gain weight. You better hit bullseye, the kid don't play. If there was a problem, yo, I'll solve it. Check out the hook while my DJ revolves it. MCs like a pound of bacon, burning them, getting quick and nimble. I go crazy when I hear a cymbal and a hi-hat with a souped up tempo. I'm on a roll, it's time to go solo. Rolling, hit my 5.0, put my rag top down so my hair can blow. The girl is on standby, waiting just to say hi.
Did you stop?
No, I just drove by, kept on pursuing to the next stop. I bust a left and I'm heading to the next block. The block was dead, yo, so I continue to A1A.
Beachfront Avenue.
Girls were hot, wearing less than bikinis. Rock men love us, driving Lamborghinis.
Jealous,
cause I'm out getting mine. Shade with the gauge and vanilla with the nine. Ready for the chumps on the wall. The chumps acting ill because they're full of eight ball. Gunshots ranged out like a bell. I grabbed my nine, all I heard was shells falling on the concrete real fast. Jumped in my car, slammed on the gas. Bumper to bumper, the avenue's packed.
I'm trying to get away before the jack is jacked. Police on the scene, you know what I mean? They pass me up, could run it all, I don't mean. If there was a problem, yo, I'll solve it. Check out the hook while my DJ revolves it. Rhymes you can vision and feel. Conducted in form, this is a hell of a concept. We make it hype, and you want us to print this. Shape plays on a fade, slice like a ninja, cut like a razor blade so fast. Other DJs say, damn, if a rhyme was a drug, I'd sell it by the gram. Keep my composure when it's time to get loose. Magnetized by the mic while I kick my juice. If there was a problem, yo, I'll solve it. Check out the hook while DJ revolves it.
Ice and Ice Ice Baby.
Good afternoon, it's Gary's Bit in the Middle, coming to you live from the roof of Broadcasting House. We just had a look at the old barometer before, 106 degrees in the shade, that is. I actually left my barometer out in the sun by mistake, and it just shot off the dial. And when I tell you that it's 120 degrees at the top, it just went zoink right the way past that. 106 degrees in the shade, and it's absolutely glorious. No, it's not. I'm hot. I'm too. No, no, I'm not going to say that. I'm never going to admit that. I'd much rather be hot than cold. We're by the paddling pool here. Can you hear that? Yeah, we're just doing the show in the paddling pool. And I promise you a lot of cool guests during the programme this afternoon. I'm a man of my word. One of the coolest men in the business, Bob Geldof. Hello, mate.
Oh, Gary, not at the moment, mind you.
Oh, I don't know. You're looking cool. I mean, everybody around here, they're all sweating buckets. We've got a few fat bellies.
Well, you've either got of... it or you haven't. What can I say?
We've got a few flabby bellies sat down over there.
Well, they're the BBC louts, aren't they? This is the lager loud contingent over there.
And there's you with your long hair and not one ounce of sweat. I mean, well, how do you do it?
Chauffeur-driven car, I think. air conditioning. No, but I do have my mega shorts on.
They are. I just don't know how to describe these
Prince
shorts.
Of Wales check, Prince I think, would start.
Yeah, they're new ones. I mean, you bought
they
those
are.
Summer.
I bought them in a closing down sale. They were a tenner. And I think that it was well worth it for everyone to see my knees. What do you think?
Hang on, can we... What do we reckon on Bob's knees here?
Terrible!
They were banned on Jonathan Ross the other night. I mean,
yeah, I heard a story about that. You were doing Jonathan Ross and you wanted to wear your shorts, and what happened?
Well, I mean, you know, like, he was telling me to wear them. He said they look great, Bob, you know, and then all these girls came along. I thought I'd do a straw poll of the sort of floor crew. They said, oh, bloody awful. So then I rang the missus and she said, no, you look really sexy in them, you know. Yeah. So you know immediately you've got to change when your wife says, you know, you look good in anything, you know.
Was Jonathan Ross wearing shorts?
Jonathan, no, but apparently he did an entire show
in shorts.
And he was thrown off the air as a result. I mean, the number of complaints. That's why he wears suits.
Really?
It's for fear of revealing these hideous knees. Legs, you know.
Yeah. So, I mean, do you like hot weather? Are you glad when
the
weather's
love it.
Like
I hate when it's raining and miserable. I mean, this is seriously over the top. But I've been out of London last night. I was out of London, and it's much nicer once you get out of the town.
Yeah.
And it's at least, you know, 3 or 4 degrees hotter in town.
Mm-hmm.
So if you can get out of town, that's the place to be.
So when you go away, you always go somewhere hot, do you?
I'm not crazy about lying out on beaches, but I'll go somewhere hot to drive around and have a look-see in that. I like those sort of places.
Listen, thank you for coming down
You're
here
welcome.
Today. Great to
Thanks
see you.
Thanks for the dip.
A pleasure, anytime. Just carry on paddling away.
Right,
if you
I'll
like.
Just go and jump off the roof.
All right, here comes Paula Abdul and Knocked Out.
Okay, it's spin and win. Our cryptic clue is an apple kept the surprise queen away. An apple kept the surprise queen away. Let's go to the phones.
Spin, and win.
Firstly on the telephone in West Sussex, we've got Sarah Green.
Hello.
Not the Sarah Green.
No, one of the many other Sarah Greens.
How many are there? The millions of you?
Yeah.
What do you do, Sarah?
I work in an office usually, but I've got day off today.
You've got a day off today?
Yeah, I'm at home.
Uh-huh. You having a good time?
Yeah, it's lovely, thanks.
All right. Okay, an apple kept the surprise queen away. What do you reckon it is?
The only thing I can get from that is surprise and Power of Love by Delight. And as it's the third week, I thought maybe you would have it three times. So Power of Light Delight, Power of Love Delight.
You think we're going to be that sneaky, do you?
Well, yeah.
Yeah.
Am I right?
You think we'd actually use Power of Love three times?
Well, you've used it twice. The third time lucky, I thought.
What's that noise in the background?
Oh, I've got a fruit machine in my lounge.
It's all right for some, isn't it?
I know, yeah. Oh. I won it, actually.
You won the fruit machine?
Yeah, in a raffle.
This is getting very silly. Delight, Power of Love, I'm afraid it isn't, Sarah.
Oh Gary, can you send me a Young Fruit and Single T-shirt, please?
No.
Oh. All right, then.
I'll go on, then.
Thank you.
Only because the fruit machine's entertainment.
Yeah.
All right, Sarah, cheers.
Thank you.
Bye. Okay, let's go to Epping in Essex, where we find Judith Nicholson. Hello, Judith.
Hello.
How you doing?
I'm fine, thanks. How are you?
Yeah, I'm all right. What do you do?
Our secretary.
Are you?
Yes.
Hard at work?
Hard at work, of course.
Good stuff. Okay, good luck with this. An apple kept the surprise queen away. It's a top 40 hit single, but which one?
I think it's Betty Boo, 24 Hours.
Why?
Because an apple a day is 24 hours.
Mm-hmm.
The surprise is Boo. And the queen is Elizabeth. And Betty comes from Elizabeth.
You're too good for me, Judith. Okay, well done. We've got the spin and win wheel spinning. On there is Beat the Intro. What comes next? Mystery Artist Backtrack, Spot the Album, Lyric Question, Last Notes. Tell me when to stop.
Stop.
Backtrack.
Oh.
Yeah. So I'm going to play a piece of music backwards. You've got to tell me what it is forwards.
Okay.
All right. What album would you like?
In Excess.
In Excess?
Yes, please.
What, the new one, X?
Yes, please.
Okay. How would you like it?
CD.
CD?
Mm-hmm.
No worries. Good luck. You ready?
Yep.
Here we go. Okay, Judith.
Is it Marvin Gaye, Sexual Healing?
Marvin Gaye and Sexual Healing. Let's see if you're right. When I get that feeling. Yeah. Brilliant. Well done.
Thank you.
All right, we're getting an Excess album on the way to you.
Lovely. Thanks.
Cheers.
Bye.
Don't be afraid of your freedom.
Any old time.
from my granddaddy. Come, these are the words me hear from my granddaddy. He said nothing in this world like when a man know him free. Free from the lock, I say free from the key. Free like a butterfly, free like a bee. These are the words me hear from my granddaddy. Said it's nice to be free, nice to be free. Free from the lock, I say free from the key. Don't be afraid of your freedom.
'Cause I'm free to do what I want.
Soup Dragons and I'm Free. I've really enjoyed the program today. I just hope it wasn't too depressing for you. Enjoy the rest of the day. I'm sure you will with Steve. Have a great night tonight. And we'll do it all again tomorrow at 12. Okay? Ta-da.